chapter 1 laws of motion of science 1 okay so today we are going to see what is uniform circular motion okay before talking about uniform circular motion let us discuss what is circular motion okay just consider the object is going or moving in this direction now the same path I am converting it to two directions then here suppose three directions the same path this is one single path now what I did instead of this object moving in the single path I bend it into two path this is one path two path this is one path two path three path okay so these are how many 1 2 3 4 okay then 1 2 3 4 5 then so now as many number of paths I will change as many number of paths will change one time it will happen that we will get circular motion we will get circular motion so here what continuously we are changing the path so this motion is said to be circular motion which is moving in a circular path object moving in a circular path will be said to have circular motion or such motion is said to be circular motion okay now uniform circular motion now in uniform circular motion when it is constantly changing its speed okay suppose the object is constantly changing its speed okay the change in speed is constant or same speed we are getting constant speed we are getting then that motion is said to be uniform circular motion okay so here I can say I am having uniform circular motion but what about velocity is velocity the same here displacement will be if we consider individual point here velocity is same you cannot say because you will come to know that direction is continuously changing and we know that velocity depends on direction also speed does not depend on direction so hence I will say this is having uniform circular motion or the speed is constant here in this case constant speed speed is not changing the object is moving with constant speed in uniform circular motion but in uniform circular motion I can say the value of speed velocity is same magnitude is same but direction is continuously changing why because you can see your direction for each point you need to change it does not have single one direction we have converted that single direction into so many directions so hence you will observe that your direction is different hence velocity is not uniform velocity is not constant not uniform direction just because of direction so I can say here if velocity is not same it is different velocity or not constant or I can say non uniform velocity then the object is said to be accelerated then the object will accelerate because acceleration means change in velocity change in velocity means non uniform velocity and velocity depends on its magnitude and direction okay here magnitude may be same of speed but direction is changing so due to change in direction it is said to have non uniform velocity and whenever we will have non uniform velocity not same velocity then the object is said to be accelerated for your non uniform motion the object will get accelerated okay understood so this is nothing but uniform circular motion now if we want to measure speed for circular motion for any circular motion if you want to measure the speed your equation is same distance upon time speed is equal to distance upon time but you children might be knowing here distance is not the straight path but it is circular path this is circular So the object is moving in this path. In circular motion, the object is moving in this path. In this path means, is this circumference? Yes. This is circumference of the circle. And what is the distance covered? Your distance covered is equal to circumference. Circumference of circular path. Okay. So, divided by time as it is. So, you know circumference of formula is 2 pi r upon time is what? T. So, if you want to find speed for circular motion, you will write 2 pi r upon t. Why? Because here distance is replaced by circumference because the object is going through circular path. And whenever it is moving through circular path or it is having circular motion, a distance will exchange with the circumference because this is the distance covered by the object. And this distance is not equal, and this distance is actually equal to circumference of this circular path. And what is formula for circular path? 2 pi r. So this is the radius. You know, circle, this is radius, this is hole is what? Diameter. So in many of the problems you will come to know diameter is given to you, radius is given to you, and speed can be asked. So from that diameter you have to find radius and then substitute the value. Okay, so pi value you children know it is 3.14, or you can write 22/7. Okay, any one value you can substitute for pi, any one value, 3.14, or you may write 22/7 for solving the problems of speed whenever we are having uniform circular motion. Okay, so this is till here, till uniform circular motion we have studied motion, then we have studied distance, displacement or related to motion, physical quantities, distance, displacement, velocity, speed, acceleration. Okay, then we have seen analytical method, that was by formula of speed, acceleration, velocity, and another one is graphical method. Okay, by using graphical method we have seen equations of motion, Newton's equations of motion. So this is very important half part of the chapter. Now left half part that we are going to see now is Newton's laws of motion. Newton's laws of motion. Okay, so we have studied Newton's equations of motion. Now we are going to study laws of motion. Before starting for laws of motion, we'll see few of the examples in our day-to-day life which will give you certain idea. That we say that static object does not move without application of external force. I am repeating the sentence. The sentence is very important. Static object means the object which is at rest. Okay, object at rest will not move until external force is applied. Until we do not apply external force, the object will not move. Means suppose the object is at rest. Rest means static. Okay, so this object at rest will not move. It will move by itself? No. Unless we apply external force, it will not move. Okay, this is one of the example you children know. Then if I want to lift any object, if I want to lift this duster from the table, it's very easy for me to lift. But if I want to lift this table, it's very hard for me to lift. I can't even hold also properly. So, or if we take any fruit, if we move or if we shake that plant, what will happen? That particular fruit will fall in downward direction, or it will fall down only. Okay. Or you can see that electric fans, when we switch off the button, after switching off also, it just, the time we switch off, it is not being switched off, or we can say it will still move for certain time. So why is this happening? This is due to inertia. This is due to inertia. Now what does inertia means? Inertia is टेंडेंसी ऑफ एन ऑब्जेक्ट और एबिलिटी ऑफ एन ऑब्जेक्ट. To be in its own state of motion or own state of rest. Okay, by example you will understand very easily. Suppose this is the bus. Okay, and here you are sitting in the bus. Okay, so children, the bus, suppose we'll take the ability of an object to be in its state of motion. In its state of motion means ability or tendency of this object is to be in motion. Your object is suppose a man or a boy or you sitting in the bus. Now you just imagine that you are sitting in the bus. Okay, the bus is in motion. What is its tendency? Motion. The bus is already in motion. And what is its tendency now? To be in motion only. So the bus is in motion. Okay, the bus is moving, hence the chair is also moving with the bus and you are also moving in the bus, so you are in motion. Suddenly the bus or the driver of the bus applies brake. As soon as he applies the brake, what will happen? Which jerk you will find, children? Forward or backward jerk? Definitely forward jerk. Just imagine that you are sitting in the bus. Bus is in motion and suddenly brakes are applied. After application of brake, which direction jerk you are getting? Forward or backward? Forward jerk. Why we are getting? Because the tendency of the object is to be in motion. Okay. Now the bus is moving and suddenly brakes are applied. After brakes are applied, the upper part of the object, this means this motion, the man sitting in the bus is still in motion. So, it is still in motion, but the lower part of the body is in contact with the chair, with contact of the bus, and the bus is stopped. So, lower part is still at rest, but the upper part which is still moving. Now instead of you sitting, just observe that you are standing. You are standing. What you will observe when the jerk, which jerk you will get? Forward jerk. But what whenever we are standing in the bus and we feel forward jerk, at that time only your legs which are in contact with the bus are still at the rest. But your till knee part you will observe or you will feel forward jerk. Okay. So this is what? The ability of an object to be in the state of motion, and this is known as inertia. This we are talking about motion, hence it is said to be inertia of motion. So what is definition of inertia of motion? Ability of an object to be in its state of motion. Same thing for rest. For rest, consider the object is not in motion. Okay, the object is at rest. Now what will be its inertia? Inertia will be tendency of an object to be in its state of rest. Now the object is at rest means imagine that the bus is at rest, bus is not moving, bus is standing at the bus station. Suddenly the bus starts to move. When bus starts to move, which jerk you will get, children's? Backward jerk. Just imagine these things. Okay, so which jerk you will feel? Backward jerk. And why backward jerk? Because your body is in rest. Okay, the body is in rest, the lower part of body which is in contact with the seat of the bus is in rest. The bus is rest, the seat is also, and you are also, what you are sitting in this seat, you are at rest, the bus is also in the rest. Now, when it starts to move, what is the tendency of the object to be in the state of rest? So, what will happen? The bus will move, the chair will move, the lower part of the body will move, and we will observe which jerk? Backward jerk. So, this is nothing but what? Inertia of rest. Okay. Now, just imagine you are sitting in the bus. The bus is in motion. Suddenly, the bus moves in left direction. What will be your tendency? Your tendency will be to be in the same direction. So, that's why when you are moving in the bus, and suddenly bus is taking the turn, you feel which outward jerk. It is not outward jerk, outward pull. What is happening? Anybody is pulling you? No, no one is there to pull you. But what is the tendency of the body? To be in its inertia of direction. So this was the initial direction. So its tendency is to be in this direction. Suddenly the bus moves. That's why we get outward pull. And when bus, after some time, we try to manage our body. In the three situations we do, we try manage our body with lower and upper part of your body. Understood? So this is inertia of motion, inertia of rest, and inertia of direction. Okay, so let us see this. Depending on this, Newton's first law of motion. Okay. So, it is said, also it is called as inertial law of motion. I'll explain why. Okay, what is its statement? Every particle continues in its state of rest or in a state of uniform motion unless external unbalanced force is applied on it. Okay, every particle, here particle means each and every object, I am talking about every object in the universe, continues in its state of rest or in a state of motion. These are two states, just understand, in its own state. In its own state means either state of motion, state of rest or state of direction. Okay, so we are talking about all the state. Don't just make it more long for understanding. While writing, you better write state of rest, state of motion. Okay. But till here only we'll see every particle continues in its own state. Own state means either state of rest, uniform motion. So each and every particle is in its own state until what? External unbalanced, unless external means bahar se, outside. Unbalanced, the body itself will not apply force, but external force should be applied. Unbalanced force is applied on it, and until we do not apply force, it will not move. Okay, so we'll see this in very detail. Okay, so children, here every particle means every object we are talking about. It continues. Continues, it means it remains. Every object remains in its own state. Own state means either rest or motion. If the object is in rest, it will be in rest only. If it is having uniform motion, it will be moving in uniform motion unless. Unless means till the time we are not applying external. External means bahar se. Unbalanced means which is net force is not equal to zero. Unbalanced, I'll explain, force is applied on it.